Well, time for some Bring It On email. You ready?
Yeah.
This first one, Pat, is a viewer who says, my husband used to love evangelizing, fasting, and serving the church. I feel that somehow after our kids were born, he didn't want to do this so much, and he won't tell me why. So instead of bugging him, I want to know how I can inspire him once again spiritually to do the things I know he loves doing. What should I do?
Well, I would suggest that you see if you can't find a time, a retreat. Some organization is having a spiritual retreat, like a weekend, where there's some intense Bible study and prayer and worship. I don't know what communion you belong to, but find one that is compatible. And see if you and your husband can't go to that. And in that environment, see if something doesn't happen. You never know why people get cold and dead, but it's so easy for it to happen. You suddenly lose the fire, and then one thing leads to another and another and another, and before long, you know, it talks about break up your fallow ground. You know, we talk about farming, but if you don't plow a field, if you just leave it under the sun, it bakes and gets hard, and you have to put a plow in there to break it up so it'll accept the seed. So there has to be a time of breaking up to get back to where you are. And this is something that happens to almost everybody. The love and the fire that was there, you know, the Bible talks about your first love. You know, you rekindle your first love.
Yeah.
All right.
This is Gary, Pat, who says, if your spouse isn't in agreement with you in tithing, should you not tithe? I've wanted to and discussed it, only to have it turned into an argument. Do you have any suggestions? So this is the husband talking to the wife.
I think it's a question of who makes the money. It's to Gary. You have a paycheck. If you want to tithe your paycheck, by all means, do it. You don't have to have your wife's permission. And in terms of the wife, the same thing. But on the other hand, if you get a allowance for you trying to get your husband to give his money or your wife to give her money, then that's a different matter. But there really needs to be harmony. God didn't want to have the question of tithing become a matter of family dissension where people break up. You know, you need to be in agreement, and let the Lord show you an agreement. But again, if you get paid some money, you don't have to give it to your. I mean, it's, you know, it's your paycheck. So if you want to take a piece of it out, just like the government takes a piece out, you don't argue about whether you're going to pay taxes. You just pay them. All right, couple minutes.
Okay, this is Gerald who says, Pat, is there any truth to the rumor that Obama is trying to regulate the internet so he can tax it like a public utility?
Well, sort of yes and no, but the Congress is actually proposing to treat the internet as a utility, and that doesn't necessarily mean something taxed, but it means it would be regulated, and once it's regulated, of course, it begins to be taxed. I think they ought to keep their hands off the internet because it's been the seedbed of just incredible creativity, but the progressives are going after anything that you know, you can tax. They want to tax it.
Exactly. This is Kent who says, it says in the Bible not to be prideful. Is it wrong to take pride in your profession to make sure your customers get a quality product? I do take pride in making sure they do get a quality product. Is this wrong?
I think the answer is yes. It's not wrong because pride in what we accomplish, there's a desire to have excellence, and desire to have excellence comes from God. God is excellent. He does excellent things. And so that isn't prideful. It's prideful when you look at it and you say, look what I'm doing, and I'm better than the next guy, and because of I'm so much more service to my customers, I'm a better company. And mm-hmm. So that's pride. It's setting yourself against somebody else, but trying to provide excellence in your life, to achieve well in school and so
on. That honors God.
Huh?
That honors God.
That honors God, absolutely. Mm-hmm.